that all you see is violence in movies and sex on TV.
But where are those good old-fashioned values on which we used to rely?
A show that I was introduced to, you know, years ago by my my own kids, you know, because we could never, you know, agree on a cartoon. I like to watch, you know, the Bugs Bunny and all that. And then I sat there with him, and I fell absolutely in love with Family Guy. Alex Borstein, welcome to the Jay Thomas Show. How are
you? Thank you for having me on the Jay Thomas Show. I'm great.
This is so cool. Lois is on the phone, man. This is awesome.
Shirley
Lois,
is here.
You've got Lois, you've got Alex, and you got Cherry.
All I'm missing is my bong, and I'd be right back in my living room right now.
How do you pronounce Cherry's last name? How do you pronounce Cherry's last name?
It's Chiva Pravat Dumrong.
Wow.
You're a real person? You're not a character?
I am a real person, yeah. The internet may say otherwise, but...
Well, we were looking at your name, Chavat. Actually, if you look, it's easy to pronounce once you get a glass of water for yourself and,
yes,
and really sit down and take a look at it. Chevat, Cheva, is that a married name or is that your maiden name?
It's my maiden name. It's my parents' name. When they came from Thailand, they did not bother to shorten anything. So we've just been using this the entire time.
What would they could have shortened it to so many things.
They could have, yeah, they could have.
And Cheva?
We're going to Cheva when we feel like it.
But. Cheva or Dumrong would have been a good last name.
And what it means in English is try and say this, Whitey. Yeah.
Now, Alex Borstein, we know that you're promoting an episode of Family Guy.
Aired Sunday night. It was a fabulous Mother's Day extravaganza.
Excellent episode, by the way.
Thank you. I wrote and that, of course, dealt with Lois. What a coincidence, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It had Lois running for the mayor of Quahog. And of like all people who get into office, they immediately get a book deal. So now we got a book to sell.
And it's really great, Jay, because it shows like the how easy it is to get votes with these people out there, like these politicians. You know, at first Lois is sitting there and she's giving her platforms and her ideas on what needs to change, and nobody can give a crap. And then this guy comes out and mentions one key word or something, never really answers the question, and all the voters flocked him. So she realizes that it's all smoke and mirrors to get your votes. You know,
right? As soon as he says, you know, what are you going to do about crime? She just simply answers. A lot.
What do you think about
new taxes? 9/11 was bad.
Now, Cherry, Cheva Pravat Dumrong. Am I saying it right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't feel bad. He can't say Smith right sometimes.
Can you tell I was a smart ass from very early in life? Are you married now?
No.
Okay. Because sometimes I read these the New York Times and I have a thing where I wonder if the woman is going to keep her maiden name or take the guy's name, you know.
Oh,
it's a
yeah.
contest.
No, I
have with
going
my
going anywhere until I find unless I find somebody with a longer last name.
You just have to keep adding to it.
I know. I'll just make it really ridiculous.
There are some Jewish names that like Feinberg at the end of it.
Or, perfect.
Yeah. Would you say it one more time before we talk back to Alex again? One more time.
Cheva Pravat Dumrong.
Chivat Pravat Dumrong.
Yeah.
Hey, Jay, good job.
Chivat Pravat Dumrong.
That's a good way to remember.
Hey, Alex, by the way, is over there with Seth MacFarlane, you know. I did American Dad.
Nice. Good for you.
But no one acts like they like that show. You're not on that show, are you? The American Dad show?
I'm not on that show. You know, at the time that show was created, Family Guy was still dead. We had been canceled.
Right, right.
So I actually had come in and read and auditioned for the mom on that show. But the network was very concerned that it was too similar. It's going to be too similar to Lois. And thank goodness that was the case because maybe a week later, it's like, guess what? Family Guy is going to be back.
Yeah, so, but you do so many voices. You could have done, you know, the mom over there and, you know, the whole
thing. Maybe. It may have started to, you know, I add a lot to the characters and write for Family Guy, too. It may have started to dilute the potion a little bit. You know what I mean? If you start spreading your seed too thin, you know, you get crazy mongoloid-looking babies, right, guys?
They had me come in there, and I play the best friend who's a right-wing atheist or something like that, you know?
Perfect. So typecasting? After the
phone call, just ask around and say, hey, what'd you think of that Jay Thomas in that episode of American Dad? Now, are they picking up? I mean, you guys are back and happening at Family Guy?
Oh, yeah. We are very much alive. You know, the shows take 9 months to make, Cherry can attest to from her hours in the writer's room.
Yes.
And so we're already a year ahead. You know, we're already screening and looking at and rewriting things that are going to be next season. So we know we're at least going to be on another season, that's for sure.
Well, you know, they were great to my 13-year-old who wants to be a cartoonist and all this stuff. They showed him. It just was like a bunch of, it was like high school with money in that place, right?
Yeah,
there's a ping pong table.
The nerds in high school.
It's pretty fun. We've got a ping pong table. We've got like arcade games here and all the candy you can eat. So
lots of candy.
I wanted to ask.
It didn't look like marijuana would be thought of as a bad thing.
Yeah, we do have outdoor deck areas.
Yes.
You did have the deck area. We have Alex Borstein. Of course, you know her as Lois from Family Guy.
Hello, and, you know me as Lois.
I have a question
and then
for sure.
Sherry, Cheva Pradvat Dumrung.
Yeah, close.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah.
Can Lois say that last name, please? Lois, would you say the last name?
Dumrung.
Nice.
Cheva Pradvat Dumrung.
But you also play the announcer, the Asian announcer on the show, don't you?
Standing here today, Thomas.
Trisha Takanawa.
Yes.
I love that.
Why don't you, Cherry, write a character that has your last name?
I know. We may work in it at some point.
Well,
I don't know.
The show's only a half hour. They can't.
I know.
They couldn't say it. By the way, the Cherry thing is also, is that a Vietnamese name also, Cherry?
That's just a nickname my parents gave me when I was a baby.
But, now, you are the writer. Why are you on the show with us today? That's the other question. I thought maybe you were just a friend of Alex's that she wanted to have help.
No, yeah, we can't stand each other.
Yeah, no.
You wrote the episode?
Together, but other than that, we hate each other.
We co-wrote the book together. Her and I are the two female writers on Family Guy.
Well, Family Guy, It Takes a Village Idiot, and I Married One is the name of the book.
Yep.
Now, okay.
Can I ask
it's for
Sherry?
Sale everywhere. Well, no, this is the promo. This is the plug.
Go ahead.
This is why they're here.
Go ahead.
Buy the book. Go to... or go to www.alexborstein.com. And the book is about your adventures in Family Guy. Is that correct?
No, the book is a tie-in to the episode where Lois runs for office. So it is Lois Griffin's political story. Much like Hillary Clinton wrote It Takes a Village, we wrote It Takes a Village Idiot, and I Married One.
See the correlation there?
And
oh,
you're
yes.
putting this out right at the when all the other political books are coming out, right?
Yep, that's what we wanted. We
yes.
thought
well,
maybe
it's
I'd
good.
Throw my hat in the ring for president.
So
right. hurry down yes. to Borders, Jubies or Lubies or whatever you call your bookstore and buy it.
Go ahead, Shuli.
Oh, okay.
Was that too harsh?
No, at all. I was just
harsh.
I thought
harsh. Go ahead, try us.
Yeah,
you can do. It's Sirius Satellite. You can almost do anything.
Oh,
we're not sure who's listening.
Stroke yourself yeah. and then buy this, but don't get it sticky.
Thanks. Let me, Sherry. You're a writer on the show. I wanted to ask you: Was there something that you guys ever wrote that at first you looked at and you go, you know what, we're not going to get away with this, and then you guys did it and it ended up being like a really funny thing in the show? Like, because some of the jokes you guys do are borderline. They're like they're pretty harsh. I mean, they're all funny. Don't get me wrong, but
yeah.
you guys walk that fine line.
Yes. There's stuff every single week that ends up getting cut out because of the FCC or the Fox standards. People are, you know, scared. We're going to offend someone. But the cool thing is that a lot of the times, the stuff that we can't show on Fox, we end up showing on Cartoon Network.
Oh.
We definitely end up showing it on the DVD.
Oh, great.
Yes, it's a three-step process.
It is. You know, it's like we'll, on Fox, it'll be like a lot of pixelation, and then on the DVD, suddenly there's Peter Griffin's genitalia everywhere. So.
Right.
You know, one of my favorites.
When you guys cut away to a real person and say they're on drugs or whatever, right, mm-hmm. has anyone ever sued you for a comment that you made about them, or called up and was pissed off, or do you have to check with anybody when
the
you...
The only person that got mad at us was Carol Burnett, who,
yeah.
yes, is still alive. that's how we found out.
And apparently has an attitude.
Yeah, she was upset. She was offended that someone mentioned her after 50 years, I guess.
What did you say about Carol Burnett?
We had a gag that Peter was saying, we're going to go into this porn shop. Quagmire says, come into my porn shop, and they're like, no, it's filthy. He goes, no. This one's not filthy. Carol Burnett works here. You pan over and it's Carol's, that little animated maid lady she did, dipping into the thing, mopping up, you know, sperm off the floor.
Oh, my God.
Classic.
And, now, you know what? I've actually met Carol Burnett a couple of times, and mm-hmm. she seems like a nice person. Is that when they get old, they think that they're supposed to be more important than they really are?
I mean, it may be that you know, humor changes, and she may have just thought it was an attack as opposed to, no, this is just a joke. It's not, we're not actually saying that's what you do now is clean up semen.
We're making
a little joke because your little character had a mop. That's all. You know?
Yeah, it was like just a pop culture reference. You know,
right.
From, hey, let's refer to this thing that happened back in the day, so...
But maybe she's...
But you know what? I think it's the sperm that probably got her upset. Mopping the sperm. Surely, don't you think mopping the sperm is what got Carol upset?
No, I don't think it was her name. I don't think so. I think the problem with it was that the cartoon drawing of Carol Burnett didn't tug on her ear like she used to do at the end of the show.
That was a follow-up joke. She tugged on her ear, and then Peter said, you know, she tugs on her ear to say hello to her grandmother. I wonder what she tugs to say hello to her grandfather.
So that may also have gotten her a little
upset. Now that tells you the genius writing that is on the Family Guy.
Who did you guys cut away to? You said they were a drug addict, and you cut away to the human. It was a woman, and you said she was a drug addict.
It was Alyssa Milano.
Oh, my God. I'm watching the show, and whatever the line was. Do you remember the line about Melissa Milano? Alyssa Milano?
I don't remember what we said about her. Do you, Cherry?
Oh, I don't.
But I know the lawyer.
You said she's a drug addict.
I'm on it.
Yeah, she's a drug addict. It cuts to her live in her living room as if she lives with her lawyer.
Yep.
And the lawyer, she goes, did you hear that, Stewie? I'm on it, you know?
And the lawyer was actually performed by one of our writers, Ricky Blitt.
That's great.
Kind of a fun little bit of tidbit knowledge. He also wrote.
Now, Shuley is so excited that you're here. Alex Borstein from Family Guy.
I am, man.
The book is Family Guy, It Takes a Village Idiot, and I Married One. It's about Lois, who has been newly elected the mayor of Quahog.
And Chiva Prava Dumrong.
By the way, I can only do really short English names. That's why I picked Jay Thomas. Shuley, go ahead.
No, I was just saying that, like, the next week's stoner meeting, when I tell them that I got to talk to Lois, they're just going to be in shock. It really is. There's so few shows that you laugh the entire show. This is one of those shows that is just funny from start to finish. They just don't go wrong. They had a reference this week's episode about going on vacation, and Peter says, you know, he goes, that last vacation we went on with the Swiss Alps guy from The Price is Right. And you remember The Price is Right game where the yodeler guy was climbing up the mountain? And it shows the whole family on the same track behind him, like climbing up the mountain. And he said, we should have gone to Plinko instead. You know, just small, throwback references. I love the show, the characters.
That's what I think people love about it is those little references. There's going to be 100 of them in every show,
yeah.
And maybe 4 of them are going to sit with each person. You know, there's something for everyone. It's kind of cool.
Well, what I like is that it's obvious that Lois likes to screw,
You said it, baby.
And she's kinky, too.
Yeah, you had some lesbian, tendencies for a while, didn't you?
I dabbled.
She went through an S&M phase for a little while.
Yeah. I mean, that is really what makes me laugh. Now, the kids, you know, now they're getting stuff. But when I first started watching it, they hadn't the faintest idea all they knew, a dog was talking. And let me ask you this. When the baby is saying all this horrible shit to you, was the original idea behind it that let babies do gibberish, and this child is really doing gibberish, and
right.
You don't understand what he's saying,
exactly.
And that
we
all
get,
babies... Is that it?
We get the gist that he's unhappy, he's moody, he's complaining, but I don't exactly hear that he wants to kill me and damn you and your wretched
right.
womb.
Right. Because when the babies are going, what we're hearing, of course, is you bitch, I want to all that stuff.
Yeah.
Wow. All right. Hey, listen, thank you very much, Alex Borstein. Family Guy's been around forever. One question I have is, why is it you think they let cartoon characters get away with stuff that they would never allow, especially in this atmosphere lately, on a live person, say, on a sitcom or something?
Carrie, Alex? What do you think?
I think just cartoon characters, they're bright, they're colorful, they sort of look kind of harmless already, so I feel like, you know, there's just a lot.
Yeah, it's like administering cyanide with a lollipop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, do you not get the same, would you not get the same complaints from an advertiser or from people watching that a regular person would get?
Yeah, I think we do not get, crushed down as harshly because we're animated. We get away with a lot more, and we're on later. But I think that's because we are animated. We get away with a lot more than, like, King of Queens could, let's say.
Yeah, how silly do you look protesting? You know, you make up a sign and you're walking around in a circle, and the lead character of the show has balls for a chin. Like, you know?
Yeah, it's like, what are you doing?
Yeah, like, how strong behind this are you?
One of my favorite stories to tell is that, you know, one time the standard said we could not do something, and it forced us to look deeper and come up with something a little more creative. And
right.
What it was is we were mentioning the word Dirty Sanchez.
Beautiful.
Thank you. And they said, can't do it, as soon as they found out what it was.
Right.
It took them a few weeks, and then we were forced to think hard.
Do you know that I don't know what that is?
Jay, really? You got to get on the internet more.
I know. And I laugh.
It's a kinky sexual thing, and right. We were forced to go around it and come up with something a little more creative. And
does it have to do with your poop shoot?
Yes, it does.
Yes, okay. Your poop shoot and another person's chin and
upper lip.
Is it a schmeckle and a schmutzky? Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, there's a schmeckle in the schnutz, and well, we'll get into it later.
So anyway,
even though it's serious, we can say what we want to say. It's more fun. I'm sorry, I'm Alex, I'm stoned that I'm interrupting you. Go ahead.
The new term we were forced to come up with was Muddy Ramirez.
which is now what I will be using from now on.
Yeah, now all of our favorite expressions, and we've coined
but
a new
worse.
Term.
It's worse.
Now they probably wouldn't let us do it again, you know? We've created it.
Well, no, I don't know what Dirty Sanchez is, but I know what a Muddy Ramirez is immediately. I knew exactly what you meant by Muddy Ramirez.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, that's great. And even all of my interrupting didn't hurt that joke. That's a good joke. Jay of Massachusetts, 888-4102-102. Alex Borstein is with us, and Cherry, her Vietnamese friend, who helped write the...
She's from Thailand.
From Thailand. Family Guy, It Takes a Village Idiot, and I Married One is the book, and of course was the episode. Hey, Jay of Massachusetts, what's your question for Alex?
Hey, guys, great show. I just had a question. What is the relation with Rhode Island? Because you guys tap and hit so many jokes on that little state. It is phenomenal where I live close to Rhode Island, so I get a lot of it, and I'm sure a lot of people across the country don't even tap into how funny it really is.
That is because of our leader, our brave leader, Seth MacFarlane, is from that area. He went to RISD, Rhode Island School of Design.
Oh, yeah.
So that's why all of that stuff exists. Half of us, you know, have no idea what we're even talking about when him or another writer named Danny Smith, who's from that area, they coin all that stuff and come up with it.
It is. I find it 10 times funnier than probably people on the other side of the country because he nails it on every point. It's great. Great job, guys.
You're welcome.
Well, you know, the Farrelly brothers are from Rhode Island, aren't they? The Farrelly brothers
right.
And they shoot. Who was on line three back there, Garrett? Who's that on line three?
It's Jeff from New Hampshire. You want to do I'm wrong. Dave from New York. You want to talk about
Dave
Falwell.
Jerry Falwell died, Alex and Cherry. Jerry Falwell, the asshole evangelist, is dead. My question of the hour is, what do you think? He died this afternoon. He had lunch, went to his office, and dropped dead. Here's my question, Alex. What do you think greeted him on the other side?
Maybe Hitler?
I said a black Jesus.
Black Jesus? Cherry, what do you think was waiting for Jerry Falwell on
like
the other side?
I like that black Jesus idea.
See?
You know what? Listen, I'm sure you guys will be writing about it as soon as the phone hangs up, but he really did die. And I, of course, believe that he's a terrible, terrible person. And I'm sorry if you're religious, and I apologize and all that, but I think it's funny that there's probably nothing there. But what do you think was there, Cherry, waiting for him? Waiting for Jerry Falwell. He gave his whole life to this idea.
Hopefully, you know. Another cutaway that we're about to write as soon as I go back in the room and tell
another
us.
Another cutaway.
Nice.
Do we have our Jerry Falwell music to say goodbye?
I am the God of Hellfire, and I bring you fire.
There you go. All right. That's what I think's waiting for his ass. Alex Borstein and Cherry.
Chevra Prava Dumrong.
I swear to God, I may just fly back to L.A. and start dating you just so I can learn how to say that name.
Oh, yeah.
In bed. Family Guy Takes a Village Idiot, and I Married One is the book. Thank you so much. We're all huge fans, and it just keeps going and going. And remember, when you get off, say, hey, how did you think that Jay Thomas did when he played the best friend on, the other show? Okay.
Right.
You want a return performance? Is that what you want?
I need a callback, actually, from you later, you know, to say, Jay, it was really, they hated the accent. But
hey,
all right.
Hey, Cherry?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you can, and I'll send you money for it, if you could slip in one of the characters, if they could just say a shalom biatch in my honor, I would love that.
We'll see if we can work that in.
All right. we could do that for Mort Goldman. Why not?
Yes. Yes. I love it.
When I was working in terrestrial regular radio, whenever we had a guest on, you know, a personality of any type, they'd go, the programmer, make sure you get Lois to say, I listen to the Jay Times show all the time. And I'm just sitting here thinking, I've never done that before. Would you say, hi, this is Lois, and I listen to the Jay Thomas show on Sirius Stars? I would think that'd be funny.
I mean, I'm going to watch the show regardless, religiously, sure. No matter what. I just think it would be great to be ripped out of my mind and hear that, and then I'd crap myself.
Well, can you do that with feeling?
Right, here we go. Anytime, Alex. You let me know. I'm there, Mama.
I need that promo, Lois. I need that promo from Lois.
What would you like?
Hi, I'm Lois.
I can't believe you're doing this, Jay.
And I listen to the. We've never done one. And I listen to the Jay Thomas show at Sirius Satellite. And I hope if he gets fired, he gets another really good job.
You're listening to what?
That's, you know, perfect. What? We'll just use that.
Yeah, that's all we need. That's all we need. You did. Yeah.
Thomas?
How do you pronounce that?
Oh, I'm going to change my name to Muddy Ramirez, is what I'll be the rest
of the day. This is Lois Griffin from Family Guy, and you're listening to Muddy Ramirez on the Muddy Ramirez Show.
Alex, thank you.
Yeah.
Sherry, thank you very much.
You guys,
good luck
awesome.
With the book, and thanks for everything that you've given to this great nation of ours, okay?
You're welcome.
Thank you.
All right.
We'll
thank you so
later.
Much. Okay, thank Bye. You. Bye.